Dole again for her beneficial to our presentation today for reference. Before we start, I'm going to start off with a video. This video is comprised of videos in Spain and England. These are my personal videos, so just hold on tight for one moment while I bring it up.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build the wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay.
Thank you, Mary. I am Dion. I am the executive director for Rome Abroad. So Rome Abroad, as it is, if we hope to give you a better understanding of what it means to study internationally and, or simply put, study abroad. So Rome Abroad was founded in 2011, and the simple concept came from personal experiences or personal stories. So for instance, as for me, one of the issues I had for study abroad is the misunderstanding. So in my foreign language class, our teacher, our professor, gave us a sign-up sheet to study for Costa Rica. As great as it sounds, as ambitious and as much of a fantasy as it is, there are some questions that was in the air that wasn't really answered. One of the questions that I was asking in my head and other students as well was, for one, the cost. How expensive is it to go to Costa Rica? How expensive is it exactly? I know there's also a currency conversion if you go out of country. And can I afford it? She wasn't really clear on that. The other question I had was the travel. So where are we going? We're going to Costa Rica, right? But also, when exactly are we going? The schedule or whatnot in particular? But also, how long are we going to be there? And those particular questions on travel, she wasn't really sure about that as well. But last but certainly not least, once we're there in Costa Rica, what is it about the culture? Do I need to know the culture of Costa Rica before I get there? What about the language? And that's one of the biggest issues. Is do you need to know a certain language? Costa Rica is a Spanish-speaking country. Do we need to know Spanish before we even go there or research? So these things, as vague as they were, as a result, didn't really inspire me to motivate me enough to sign up to go and study abroad in Costa Rica. So that's where we come in for Rome Abroad, for our purpose statement. We want to give you clarification and more awareness on the opportunities of what it means to study abroad. We want to give you clarification, because we want you to be clear, and that is our motivation, that's what drives us. But to do that, we need to have competent team members and people come to play. And that's where we have Chastity Young. She's our chief operating officer. She's been with the company for 4 years. She has a bachelor's degree in finance at the University of Florida, master's degree in marketing at the University of Florida. We also have Ivy Zhang. She's our chief of financial operations. She's been with the company since 2011. She's been part of the original faculty, as me and Mary, bachelor's degree in finance and accounting at the University of West Georgia. Next, we have me, as I introduce myself. I'm also a part of the original faculty for 5 years, founded in 2011. Bachelor's degree in mass communications, and I went to University of Georgia, UGA. Now we have Cameron Futrell. She's our vice president. She's been with us for 4 years, master's degree in marketing at Auburn University. And last but certainly not least, we have our president, Mary Morris. She's been with the company, original faculty, since 2011. And a bachelor's degree in marketing at NYU and master's degree at NYU. So overall, we are Roma Rob. We want an image to make the dream work. Teamwork makes the dream work. There's no I in team. So simply, as cliche as that sounds, it's cliche for a reason, because it is right. We rather than me. And as much as we want to help you, we also want you to help us. What are your questions? What are your comments? And what are your concerns in regards to studying international or simply studying abroad? And to further continue this presentation, I'll bring up Mary Morris for our statement of need. Take it away, Mary.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So for the statement of need at Rome Abroad, first we're gonna start off with the history of Office of Education Abroad. They started about 20 years ago on campus, and it started out with the course, the Costa Rica assignment that he was talking about with the Spanish professor. From there, the English department grew with their Italy study abroad. And then, of course, Richards College of Business has their own. You can go on spring break during the summer. Of course, you can study abroad for a year in France. And then it kind of just developed into their own Office of Education Abroad. The three things that we notice as Rome Abroad and Statement of Need, first is their social media use. The Office of Education Abroad does have their own Facebook page. If you haven't liked it, please go like it. And I'll show you a picture in just a few moments of what it looks like. The increase in campus involvement, there is banners and pamphlets, brochures, which we'll be handing out sooner or later. But the campus involvement is very slim on campus, because not many people study abroad just because of where I'm going to next is the education on expenses. Many people have this misinterpretation of how much does it really cost to study abroad. And that's why people go buy the brochures and just leave. And further ado, the communications part is next with Ms. Chastity Young. There is a graph of our Rome Abroad student participation. The green represents with Rome Abroad, and the blue is without Rome Abroad. These are a couple of schools, universities, Kennesaw State, UGA, and University of Alabama. And of course, like I said earlier, this is their Facebook page, the UWG Office of Education Abroad, and this is their home website page. As you can see, it's a little bland. It can use a little bit more emphasis on the different types of programs that they offer. And Ms. Chastity, now without further ado.
Thank you, Mary. So I'll be talking with you all about the internal and external communications. The communication process, we want everyone who's interested in doing study abroad to be enthusiastic about doing it, and we also want to make sure that we communicate with each and every one of you effectively. With that, we will have fast email responses. Any email that you send, no matter if you send it at midnight or 12 in the afternoon, it will get to you within 24 hours, and all of your questions will be answered about any concerns you have with studying abroad. Also, we would like to ensure that we have helpful and friendly staff members that are there to answer the phone when you all are making calls about any concerns, or if your parents are making calls. We understand that people that want to do study abroad are students, and we are young adults, but at the same time, since it is so expensive, many people rely on their parents to help them, so we want to make sure that we communicate effectively, not only with you, but with the parents as well. Also, face-to-face meetings, we want to make sure that it's easy to find a faculty member, no matter what department you are trying to study abroad with on campus, that you're able to meet with them during reasonable times, even if you have class, you know, late or even early in the morning. We want to make sure that there's someone there in the morning, throughout the afternoon, even in the evening, so that all your questions, and if you don't feel like you will get a good answer by email or telephone, that you will be able to meet with them face to face and get any questions answered. Here's our SWOT analysis we came up with. We have an internal and external part. The strengths, providing customer service. This is a business, and that we want to make sure that we give you the best customer service possible when you're trying to study abroad. You know, depending on, you have questions about expenses, traveling, money, and also the course that you need when studying abroad. Many students don't know that when you're studying abroad, that the class that you're taking with that program is separate. It's a separate cost from the actual program itself. So we want to make sure that we provide great customer service, because these types of questions can become difficult and frustrating students when there's no answers about this. Also, email efficiency. We'll make sure that, you know, email is very clear and correct, and that you understand what we're trying to say as faculty and students, and get our point across without any disruptions or misinterpretations about the program in the cost of the course. Some of our weaknesses, we looked at other schools in surrounding areas, and we noticed that, for one, Kennesaw State University, their website is more appealing, it's more attractive, and we would like to update the current one at the University of West Georgia so that it can be more appealing, because study abroad is supposed to be fun, it's supposed to make you really want to go out and do it. And our website right now currently doesn't make you want to do that. So we would like to get on the same track as Kennesaw State University with their website and programs. Some opportunities, like Mary talked about earlier, we would like to have more social media connections. So every student that study abroad at the university, we would like them to post a picture and maybe a description of where they went and talk about their experience. Also, we would like to have tables and events on campus. Yes, there are tables now currently when they have preview day and big events on campus, more likely when freshmen are in, but more than likely freshmen don't study abroad. So we would like to make it available throughout the whole year so that upperclassmen can know more information about it and they're able to study abroad as well. Some threats, like I talked about earlier, some threats are surrounding schools with better programs. I know many students do transfer to Georgia State or UGA or Kennesaw State just because they have better programs for their study abroad. So we would like to advance that, have more programs available for students on our campus. And here's just a composition comparison chart that we came up with. And this is our school, and this is Georgia State, and we want to get up here when it comes to communicating with our students about studying. Now I'd like to turn it over to Cameron with recommendations.
Recommendations we have for y'all is new ways to promote, establish a relationship, and achieve student awareness. With those, we have, as a big push, is social media. The more social media presence there is, the more you're going to get the word out there. Updating Facebook on a regular basis, having, you know, updating your Twitter account, possibly having an Instagram where people who have been on these trips can post their pictures. Also, Pinterest. Pinterest is kind of something that a lot of people get on whenever they're bored. I know for my personal self, if I'm sitting in a doctor's office and I'm bored and I'm on Pinterest and I see a really cool photo of any kind of travel, it'll take you to, you know, University of West Georgia's study abroad program's website. Speaking of website, I know Mary and Chastity also hit on it, but updating the website would help a lot. I know the website and the format of it was very consistent with University of West Georgia, but if you tweaked it a little bit more to make it different, to make it stand out, I think that you would get a lot more attention. With that, you could also do a bi-weekly newsletter to send out to the students in their West Georgia email. So they would also have an idea of what exactly is going on, what programs are still active, you know, the locations, prices, everything like that. Or you could also do a blog from different students and have it posted on the newsletter. here are the different social media avenues that you could take. You have Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, and Twitter. Improving student awareness, you could also attend orientations, make a presentation table, not only for just the freshmen that are coming in, but for transfer students as well. You could get the information out to them. I'm a transfer student, and I didn't know anything about the program until Mary brought it up when we started this consulting for your company. You could attend different club meetings, have a representative come and speak, you know, on the different events that you have. Have the academic advisors hand out pamphlets when students come to get advice for the classes. And again, you could send out weekly newsletters. So those are the recommendations that we have. And now I'm gonna pass it to Ivy for the conclusion.
In conclusion, our company really more well strive to serve our clients and value communicate the way we communicate with the audience. In order to improve students' awareness on study abroad from programs, I'm sorry. It's our desire to assist education abroad to attract more students involved. We are confident that our suggestions can help you and to develop in the future. For this purpose, we have recommendations to improve as internal and external communication. Like what Tamara just said, we will improve their image, campus involvement, and campus influence. In the past, based on our cooperation with other companies, they could benefit from our ideas and get success. Also, we learned a lot from the cooperation, and we grew up with the development of our minds. Thus, we have abundant experience on this kind of programs. However, the most important is we have the same goal with our clients. We know that the mission of the education abroad is to engage our students into impact and experimental learning. And our team knows that how the international education benefits students. We also hope more students can go abroad and get adjusted to different cultures. Actually, we believe that our success comes from the success of our clients. And we trust that through our cooperation, more students will know about the international education and more students would like to go abroad. That's all. Thank you. So let's be the beginning of
while they're handing out the takeouts, are there any questions for this team?
Why would working with your company be a smart investment?
Working with our company would be a smart investment because we have a lot of recommendations that are beneficial and that would actually help students be more aware of your program, and you would actually have more student awareness and attendance for your trips that we will be able to help you with.
How much time and effort will be needed to put into the recommendations that are put in place?
Can you repeat the
question?
How much time and effort will it need to be put into the recommendation to set them in place?
For the recommendations, it's really just the website and educating the students. So it depends on which one we're doing. The social media you can do like immediately. I mean, you can get on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever, anywhere. But educating the students is more of how much time are you going to spend on that in the classroom kind of thing. Yes.
Are there any risks involved with the recommendations?
The only thing that I could think of is privacy. It depends on if you're a private college or a public college. And if you want all your programs on social media, that's the only thing that we can think of privacy-wise and risk-wise.
Okay. Thank you.
Lastly, we trust the recommendations to include the department now and into the future.
You should trust our recommendations because we have valid reasons for why we chose those recommendations. And based off looking at different people's different programs, our recommendations, it will increase the engagement. And like Mary said earlier, bringing awareness, you know, will bring more money into the school and also the trip, and more people can tell their story. And the more people that do it, more likely they will tell other students on campus, and they'll just bring more, you know, profit and, you know, also awareness to the study of our program at UNS.
What do you believe our long-term potential is compared to other departments or organizations you've looked at or worked with?
I'm sorry, I can repeat that.
What do you believe our long-term potential is compared to other departments or organizations that you've looked at or worked with in the past?
Long-term wise, it would be the student involvement. Because that's our main focus, is getting more students in the programs and educating them. So long term, we get more students involved than other departments. Like the program for the English department is Italy, and the one at Richards College of Business, they have Spain, England, and stuff like that. But the Office of Education Abroad is more or less all the programs in one.
All right, so I think that's all the questions. Thank you so much, Team Number 4, and thank you, Dr. Bora.